Hello, and welcome to Quick Hits, a podcast brought to you by Borealis Threat and Risk Consulting in Ottawa, Canada. I'm your host, Phil Gurski, president of Borealis. It is the 19th of May, 2020. And the genesis for this podcast was a story I just read in the Global News, which is one of Canada's news sources. It's put out by a reporter called Stuart Bell, who is, in, frankly, in my opinion, probably the best terrorism reporter in all of Canada. I've known Stuart for, wow, going back 15 years ago. I met him when I was still at CSIS. He's written 3 books on terrorism. He's a really good reporter, and he's a really good analyst when it comes to terrorism from my perspective. And this story has just come out literally a few hours ago. And there was an attack in February of this year, on February the 24th, in which there was a stabbing at an erotic massage parlor in Toronto, which was carried out by a minor. So we can't name the person under Canadian law. Turns out that this stabbing attack, in which one person was killed and one was injured, is now being treated as a terrorist attack. I repeat, a terrorist attack. And the reason for this is that police, so this is a few months after the actual stabbing, the police have learned that the attack was inspired by the so-called Incel movement. Now, for those who aren't familiar with the Incel movement, this is a term that goes back quite some time. It refers to the term involuntary celibate. Essentially, it was created by a woman, believe it or not, but it refers mostly to men who, say it obviously, who can't get laid. Men who can't form meaningful relationships with women, can't have sex, therefore very frustrated. And of course, it is all the women's fault because they will not have sex with them. And they take it as their right to have sexual relationships, and the fact that they're being denied means that they can target women. They also have a tendency to target men who are successful at sexual relationships. And there's this whole terminology about Chads and Stacys, Chads being successful men and Stacys being successful women who have sex with Chads, I guess. The interesting part about this is that the police, in fact, have decided to lay terrorism charges in this. So not murder charges and attempted murder and not hate crime, but terrorism. And I want to weigh in on this. This is the first time in Canadian history that anti-terrorism laws who have been used to prosecute an act of violence in which the perpetrator or suspect was not, and I repeat, not an Islamist extremist. So we're going to talk a little bit about that. But let's get back to the crux of the matter. Is a crime committed by an incel, by an involuntary celibate, is it an act of terrorism? Now, historically, I've weighed in against this. If you go back to a couple years ago, I believe it was April 2018, Alec Manassian drove his van down Yonge Street, one of the major streets in Toronto, killing around a dozen people, men and women, and injuring another 20 or so. He claimed to be an incel as well. And I'm still not 100% sure that he was, because we don't have a lot of evidence to point in that direction. But Alec Manassian put out a tweet in which he referred to a man called Elliot Roger, who was a man who, way back in 2014, killed a bunch of people. He shot some, he stabbed some, and he rammed some with his vehicle. Ended up killing 6 and injuring 14 others near the campus of the University of California, Santa Barbara. And he had a manifesto entitled My Twisted World, the Story of Elliot Roger. And it was him, he's the guy sort of associated with the incel movement right now. And in fact, Manassian made reference to Elliot Roger in his tweet, saying the revolution has begun, we're all incels. Is this a good move by the Canadian government or by the police forces and by the Crown, which is the prosecution in Canada, to lay terrorism charges in this regard? I'm not so sure. I will concede that I'm coming around to the notion that incel may in fact constitute an ideology, although I am not a specialist in this matter by any stretch of the imagination. Recall that under Canadian law, in order for an offense to be terrorist in nature, it has to be committed for political, religious, or ideological reasons. So incels are not political. They're certainly not religious. Is it an ideology? I can see the argument on both sides of that fence. But let's assume for argument's sake that this is in fact an ideology and therefore the police are correct in laying a terrorism charge. Here's the problem I have with that. We in Canada do not have a stellar track record when it comes to terrorism prosecutions. Yeah, we've had a few successes like the Toronto 18, the Ottawa plot back in 2010, as well as two plots in 2013, one in Toronto, which a via passenger train was going to be derailed, and the two suspects were found guilty of terrorism, although one has had his sentence thrown out based on some bizarre court ruling about something that didn't go well during the trial. Another case out in Vancouver, in which two converts were found guilty by jury of plotting an act of terrorism on Canada Day, July the 1st. They planted pressure cooker bombs inspired by the Boston Marathon of earlier that April of 2013. They were found guilty by jury, and then the judge threw it out, said that they had been coerced by the source, by the agent, the RCMP agent. In fact, it had been what they call a Mr. Big operation, that they wouldn't have done it without the influence of the actual human agent. We've had other cases of wannabe foreign fighters who wanted to join ISIS, who've been found innocent, i.e. not guilty of terrorism. So we're not doing well on terrorism prosecutions in this country. And my question is, why do we need to go down that road in this case? It clearly is an instance of murder. It clearly is an instance of attempted murder. You could go as far to say that it's a hate crime, and hate crimes in Canada are very different than terrorism crimes. It's a different part of the criminal code. And a hate crime is a crime which targets specifically a group of people. I think we do a little better at hate crimes in Canada than we do at terrorism. My fear here is that by leveling terrorism charges against this unnamed minor, what happens if we fail? What happens if the Crown is unable to prove that this particular act of violence was carried out in the furtherance of incel, assuming it's an ideology? What happens if they can't do that? Does the person walk? Are all other charges dropped? Does the person essentially get away with murder? I just don't see the necessity at this point to insist this is a terrorism offense. And I don't want to upset those who are much well more versed than I am in terms of the incel phenomenon, if you want to use that. I just think there's other tools in the legal toolbox. And it just strikes me as interesting that they've made this decision. Now, it did take them 3 months. I'm guessing they're building their case still. So the youth would have been arrested originally and probably charged originally with murder, attempted murder, and had the charges changed to terrorism. I'd just love to see the rationale that's been used and the thinking behind changing those charges from one particular set of charge to another. I guess we're going to have to see what happens in this case, whether or not the Crown can prove that, in fact, this was an ideological offense. And if it does work out well for the Crown, this will be, as Stuart Bell pointed out in his story, the first successful prosecution in Canadian history under a terrorism charge. That's not Islamist extremism. Remember that terrorism as an offense really only exists since 9/11. Before 9/11, we had other parts of the criminal code. So I'll be watching this case very, very closely to see how the Crown does, how the defense counters the charges of terrorism. And I guess we'll have to wait and see what the result is, which could take months, if not years. So what do you think? Was terrorism the right thing to level in a crime of this nature? Do you think that incel is an ideology and therefore a terrorist movement? Love to hear what you think. You can reach me anytime on email, borealisrisk@gmail.com, or you can follow me on Twitter, @BorealisSaves. You can also reach me on LinkedIn or on Facebook. If you like the content that I provide and you want to receive it on a daily basis in a daily digest form, simply go to my website, www.borealisthreatenrisk.com. Find a subscribe button in the upper right-hand corner. Fill in your email information and you'll receive a once-a-day digest of all the material I produce, Today in Terrorism, quick hits such as this, longer intelligent look at terrorism podcasts, and perspectives. I'll talk to you again soon. Until then, stay safe.